The Astonishing Tales of King Street, Euro Cup Final Edition. Let the games begin.
Let's go, England! Pip, pip, cheerio! Yes, indeed. Quite cheerio from King Street. I hear cheering from Belfast Love, which is ironic because they're not really fans of the English, those Belfastians. What happened? Did England score?
Yes, sir.
Oh! Jolly good.
Yellow light, yellow light, yellow light, yellow light.
England!
So here I am now at half-time, feeling pretty confident right now as the score is 1-0 for the English squadron. Potentially, the Italian team could come back and strike some sort of revenge and rebellion. But how often do people strike revolutions and rebellions against the English? I mean, that's just preposterous. Now the score is 1-1, and as you see, I've removed my umbrella. It's no longer needed. Frankly, this nice weather is a bad omen for British people.
Oh my gosh, it's Christina's birthday, everyone!
I'm now at Banknote Bar with a lot of other wonderful people right here. And it is 89th minute. Is that how many minutes are in soccer?
That's a lot.
There are a few more English fans here at this other bar.
How do you feel about the English's chances?
How do you feel about spoiler alerts happening across the street? Their feed is 3 seconds faster!
Oh my god! F***ing right!
What a tournament. And congratulations, Italy. England, don't worry. We'll win next year's Euro Championship. Don't you worry.
If you want to be Euro champions, you've got to get with my friends. Kicking balls at keepers in front of nets that they do tend. Oh, if you want to be my champions,